Reese, Chud. I'm a certified functional medicine practitioner and nutritionist. Want to talk to you today about fibromyalgia and the root causes of fibromyalgia. Functional medicine practitioners, we look at the body as everything's working together. All systems affect each other. So when we look for, when we are confronted with a condition, we look for the root cause. So the root cause of fibromyalgia, there are many concomitant illnesses when one has fibromyalgia, which is globalized pain. You often see migraines, you see depression, sleeplessness, a lot of GI issues such as intestinal IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. You see a lot of concomitant issues. And one of them is 100% of people with fibromyalgia have something called SIBO, small intestinal bacteria overgrowth. What that is you normally have billions of microorganisms, and good microorganisms, you're supposed to have them in your colon. And sometimes you have bad microorganisms too that can wreak havoc on your system. But in this particular case, the good bacteria migrate up into the small intestine. And so it's the right bacteria in the wrong place. And these bacteria really like to eat carbohydrates, especially long chain carbohydrates, saccharides. And when they eat that, they produce methane and hydrogen gas. And you can feel that in your discomfort. And also it causes your serotonin to go down. Let me explain that. Also, your serotonin, which is a neurotransmitter responsible for mood and sleep and gastric motility, is mostly made in the gut. It's mostly produced, 90% of it is in the gut. So when you have a problem with your GI, you have a problem with producing serotonin. So when these organisms that are plentiful, ballistically growing in your upper GI, the die-off from them produce the casing of these bacteria are called lipopolysaccharides. And the die-off produces this methane and hydrogen, which lowers your serotonin. So the first root cause of fibromyalgia is low serotonin. And that could be responsible for your sleeplessness, your depression, and some of your other mood symptoms when you have fibromyalgia. Now, a lot of doctors will give their fibromyalgia client patients antidepressants. That can work in the short term, but in the long term, that actually can lower your body's ability to produce its own serotonin. So it's better to get to the root cause of the problem. The second root cause is that people who have fibromyalgia have been found to have higher glutamate levels, which is the largest neurotransmitter in your body. And it is the excitatory neurotransmitter. That's another reason why there's insomnia, can't sleep, because your body is excited and producing more adrenaline from the glutamate. And so what I do is I give my clients a higher amount of nutrients, which increase the opposing neurotransmitter, which is GABA, which is the relaxing neurotransmitter. The third cause is of fibromyalgia, the root cause, is mitochondrial dysfunction. Mitochondria is the kidney-shaped little sacs in every single cell of our body that produce the energy that we use and that we need. They found that people who have fibromyalgia have not only lower numbers of mitochondria, but also they produce less ATP, which is the energy. So the fourth reason of the fourth root cause of fibromyalgia coincides with the mitochondria, and that is toxicity. I come to realize that in my fibromyalgia clients, I've started looking deeper than even the it all begins in the gut. And so I've been testing them for heavy metals, which includes mercury and lead. And I've been testing them for neurotoxins, which includes a lot of pesticides that we're eating on our food. Glycoside, which is in Roundup, you've used all over the country if you're not eating organic food. So I digress. I have found that in my fibromyalgia clients, their levels when I test them are really high. I have a relatively inexpensive heavy metals test. There, it's in a urine test or a hair analysis that I send a kit out, and you take the specimen and send it in, and I get the results. Now, if you go into a doctor, if that you request a heavy metals test, they will give you a blood test. And actually, a blood test for heavy metals only reflects recent toxicity. So it doesn't reflect what I'm looking for. And I'm looking for metals that have been in your body and is becoming toxic. So I'll tell you where that's coming from. A lot, you know, if you look around, the incidence of autoimmune diseases is going rampant, fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, by diabetes, resistant weight loss, autism, everything like this is going rampant. And a lot of it has to do with toxicity. The one number one for mercury is silver fillings. Silver fillings are 50% mercury, and left in the mouth, the acidity of your saliva will slowly disintegrate some of that, and that's liberated and taken to your brain, and it's held there in your brain. It's stored forever unless you detoxify it. You can get also mercury from having your fillings removed an incorrect way. Now, that's what happened to me in my 20s, and you can see I'm not 20. In my 20s, I had my silver fillings removed and replaced with ceramic fillings. And in those days, dentists just took them out. Now, you really recommended to have a biological dentist remove them, and they have special machinery and equipment that suctions it, all of it out, 100%. So your other airways are prevented from sucking any of that mercury in because it's stored in the brain. So I started getting chronically ill in my 20s with autoimmune disease. I was chronically sick. Every 6 weeks, I would have a sinus infection. I had a lot of fibromyalgia symptoms. I personally think it was autoimmune, but I did have a lot. I started gaining weight and wasn't able to lose it. A lot of symptoms. And I trace it back to that. And when I went through my functional medicine program, I was a nutritionist for 30 years before I went into functional medicine. I got myself tested for mercury and I was really high, and I did a detox and everything became better for me. I stopped getting infections. I started having a more, be able to eat a more normal diet and not, and lose the weight and not gain it back. And my symptoms were really lessened. So anyway, so in my practice, I gave these tests to my fibromyalgia clients, and like I said, it was high. And so where did, that's where you get mercury. Well, what about lead? Lead, you know, has been around for decades. Pencils, paint, you know, they take it out now since I think 1975 they took it out. But lead is transmitted from mother to child through the placenta. So we can inherit, not hereditarily, but we can inherit the lead toxicity from our mothers. Also, neurotoxins, which I can give a simple, inexpensive test for, is present in glycoside, in Roundup, and in our food and water, and we're getting toxic levels of them, which affect our nerves. So I developed a cellular detox. So to detoxify on a cellular level, all of the mercury, all of the lead, all of the neurotoxins out of the body, it takes about 3 months. And in addition, the first month will open up some of the pathways in the liver and the kidney to allow detoxification pathways to be opened that way. I have a specific nutrients that provide for the mitochondrial regeneration of the cell membrane, and it increases the ATP production in the mitochondria. So this is a very well thought out, investigated protocol. And it, like I said, it's 4 stages and lasts about 3 months. And my fibromyalgia clients are claiming that some of their symptoms are subsiding. And it's just thrilling and amazing. And it makes sense when you think about all the toxins that are out there. So I'd like to help you if you have fibromyalgia and you have been going from doctor to doctor and not getting any help. Give me a call at 215-680-2354. I'm leaving my information on this video, and my company and website is srcdietandwellness.com, and you can contact me on that page as well, or email me at schud1234@gmail.com. Well, thank you for listening, and I hope it was enlightening for you, and I hope you get some help. Thank you.